that'll be like a different level.
That'll be a different level, it's not performance here, it's something else, I can't find the name, if the insurance can.
No, you have like, you don't come up, Steve, you have like.
You're trying to get a certification, that's different.
A one, a two, a three, you know what I'm talking about.
It's not performance.
They just call them, the state calls them performance evaluation, that's what they call all.
No, I'm talking about what he's talking about their job title or whatever, like a one, a two, a three, I know that's what, whatever your job is, you have like a level one, a level two, you know what I'm talking about?
A form one, a form two.
Yeah, yeah, that's what.
Right, if they do have that, where if you move up, if you move it up in something, you got a one now, you move up to a two.
Is that what you're talking about?
No, that's not, this is performance, no, that's not what I'm talking about.
No, but I mean, that's what you.
No, that's not what I'm talking about.
What you're saying is.
I'm just talking about the performance where he has.
You're talking about what this says.
That's what he's saying, the performance.
I was just talking about when he was like.
He's just like your supervisor come to talk to you every year, what the state does, every year.
Right.
They have a performance evaluation, yes, we have that, that tell you what you need to do, what you need to improve.
And what you need to improve on.
That's what I'm talking about, this is what I'm getting from, it's bad ways going, you doing a good job.
You're talking about that.
If a man does a better job, you're saying don't give him a.
No, that's, state don't get no raise for that now.
I don't know.
No, state don't do that, not a raise, now, if you get a new license, you're going from one, you get a new license going to two, yeah, the state might do that, but when they do my evaluation every year, no, sir, I don't get a raise, you don't get a raise, you won't get a raise, you're not gonna get a raise for that.
Well, there was a lot of abuse with it, and I think that's why they get away with it, because Mr. McKinney describes, there was a lot of abuse in it, and I think a lot of it had to do with the Department of Safety, but there was other departments too.
Others too.
But, you know, but on the other hand though too, when I was up there, it was frustrating to me, if I had two employees in identical positions with similar job descriptions, and one of them was really excelling, you know, and all this sort of thing, I was limited, I couldn't reward them. Everybody got a step. Of course, we were up there, the years I was up there, all you got was that blanket 2% raise anyway.
How often do we do raises like this? I was under the impression that if you got a raise, it was because we agreed as a whole, but I didn't know besides the police department for us getting ranks and stuff like that, but everybody else, I thought it was just, so how often is this? Has this been, I know we just put this in place, but if we just started this, what stops any department head from giving this?
What y'all are saying, if one man performs better than another man, don't reward him for it?
I'm not saying.
Y'all are talking about the state, I'm talking about.
I'm talking about Bolivar, I'm asking.
I said reward him, Mr. Mayor, but I don't know about the money part. And you come up in, we can do other ways than give him, money. He come up in and say he's doing a good job. I don't have no problem with that.
Weird.
But then, certificate, that's what state, you write more DUIs, you write more seatbelt, I guarantee you didn't get no money. But you probably got a certificate for you when they have a district meeting, you come before the captain, he give you a certificate, you go on about your way. But
I know, highway patrol is a highly politicized deal. And let me say, we have with us tonight Mr. Ronnie Neal, who is our MTS representative from the University of Tennessee, and he's also a former mayor of Somerville. Ronnie, can you give us some insight on what we're talking about here? Clarification, would you do that?
And you thought you were just coming to talk about strategic planning.
If y'all can figure out a way to give merit raises that are not subjective, that are actually based on a good system, we can start selling that tomorrow. Because this is something that everybody struggles with on how do you do an evaluation. In a factory where a person needs to make 50 widgets an hour, well, if they make 60, it's easy to tell them how much more you get. Out in the street, if the first time you reward a policeman for writing more tickets, everybody's going to say you've got a quota system.
And that's illegal.
So you can't do that. So if you can figure this one out, let me know. I will hit it out to all my other cities. Because it's a struggle. We struggled with it at UT for the last 10 years. They've been trying to figure out a way to set up a merit system for the employees, and nobody yet has been able to come up with a system that would truly be based on performance and not, when it comes down to it, just whether your supervisor thinks you're doing a good job, a better job than anybody else.
That's right. It's a double-edged sword.
It really is.
But I understand too what we're talking about here. If I've got two men and as my employees and I got $1.50 I can give you, if you're working your butt off and you're dragging your butt, then I'm going to give you 50 cents and give you $1 instead of 75 cents a piece. I think that's what we're talking about.
If it works like that, but like we were talking about earlier, I could be doing just as good, but you don't like me, or you don't like my cousin.
Well, you also get to consider it's not whether I like you or not. You get a supervisor in there that has no backbone. He just married Ray's everybody.
So that's why I said no. And I think that's where even Bredesen just decided quit doing it.
You're doing it because of that.
So are we doing this now, or is this something we were proposing to do?
We're just now starting the evaluations. They were going to be effective as of September the 1st.
Okay, so this is, nobody has got a merit raise. And I don't know if this needs to be a motion, I suggest it stay the same way. If we get a raise, it gets across the board.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it says considered and funded, and that's us. But now, as far as changing the wording for the merit and eligibility determinations, I guess that's still up to us. I'm not going to take the word merit out.
Take it off.
Considered and funded as us, so it's going to come through us anyway.
Is that your suggestion that we take that off? Do you think that would be best to take that merit off of that last sentence?
Well, let me say, I know at UT, when they do our evaluations, if you fall below a certain point, then you won't get the across-the-board raise, and you then have to go into a plan on how you improve and bring yourself up. And a lot of places have that, so that you have to score, you know, if you've got a rating scale of 1 to 5, maybe as long as you're 3, or if you get a 4, maybe you could get a little bit more, but there can certainly be some, with the evaluation, some penalty, or I guess the reward could be, as long as you're a 3 or above, you get across the board raises. If you're below a 3, then you have to work out.
Give them some incentive too.
Basically, you're saying that you do have a merit type system.
Well, not really.
I mean, it's a graded type thing.
It's graded, but.
But how do you take a man that operates equipment, digs ditches, shows up for work, he's there on time every day, he stays there at the quitting time, he doesn't linger on the job? Is he better than another guy that does the same thing, doesn't get there on time, doesn't show up, or whatever? That's what I'm talking about.
I don't think you reward. You punish that one. If you show up late for work, then you...
All right, what if he does the bare minimum?
Well, if he's doing the bare minimum, I think our job description should be high enough where if he's doing what he's supposed to do, he get his how much his pay is.
So you're saying if a guy's doing more than the bare minimum, he's better than the other guy?
I'm not comparing the two. All I'm saying is,
you
can look up here at us now. We be here at the council meeting. If I don't show up to one, that don't mean y'all better than me. I just didn't show up to one.
When you're doing a job, if you run the restaurant down there, aren't you got a cook? You got one that shows up, does a good job. One makes the food taste good. You got one that can't cook.
What he's saying. If they can't cook, then they lose their job.
that's not what he's saying, Mr. Barron. I think that's not what he's saying. I think what he's saying is if you go down below a level, you don't get the raise at all.
Do we reward somebody that does a better job than somebody that just does a mediocre job?
Reward them with a certificate or something like that. Give them a certificate. Why not have to be a raise, Mr. Barron? Give them a certificate, you know?
It's
other means that you can reward other than money. It's not money.
Let me tell you, this whole performance thing we're talking about, this is trying to help the employee and help the manager. And we're trying to develop them, let them know that we want them to do better and that we somehow are going to reward them at that. Because they're doing a better job. But then we come along and say that we cannot. I don't understand that. Can't have both.
There's other means to reward, is what I'm saying.
What are the means?
I just said a while ago, you weren't listening. I said, you give it through a certificate, or something like that. Give him a certificate. Bring him up here before the council. You know you've done an excellent job, because I like to tell him he's doing an excellent job. I like to say that myself, you know. So give him that. That wouldn't be a problem.
That wouldn't be much reward.
Because you got a job, you know. You're getting paid. You know, you're getting paid. You know,
well, of course, so the answer to that, if you've got an employee that is late, I mean, you have what the state has is a system called progressive discipline.
Right.
And when you've got an employee that is not showing up, they're not doing their job, and it becomes chronic or whatever, then you begin taking disciplinary action, where you write them up and all that.
Exactly.
And then when they, and then it's also reflected on their evaluation, where they may get, on a 5-point system, they may get 2s and 1s. And then at some point, you've got enough grounds to terminate.
That's correct.
And that's how you deal with
there
it. But they did take out pretty much part of
it. It took much to divorce your part.
Yes, sir, it did. Yes, sir.
So what we're saying, Mr. Mayor, is man that comes to work and does the bare minimum, he's just as good as a man that works his table.
It looks like we're establishing a punitive type system rather than a rewards type system. That's contradictory to what we're trying to do. We're trying to improve the performance of the people. And
I have no problem with that. I'm just afraid of the part that when you're not saying this about any other department head or any person, but how do you, like he said here, how do you make it fair and make it right across the board when you have one that's, you know, like that?
What we've got to do, we've got to identify unfair situation and deal. If it's unfair, it's like,
so okay, well, how do we do that then? That's my
Well, opinion. You come to me. If you, like this employee that's told you that you've been treated unfair, you need to come to me and tell me about it.
And then what happens when I come to you and we go to the department head about it, and then all of a sudden his work environment is not the place he wants to be?
No, not necessarily.
Let's just be real about it.
No, I ain't going to be.
Just be honest about it. I'm not accusing anybody of saying doing that, but what happens, just take employee A, and we have this meeting, and nobody likes to be the bad guy. Nobody likes to do that. And nobody wants to be the telltale or anything like that. But if I go to Mexico, okay, well, my supervisor is this, I don't think he's this, and this, and he's talking about the person that he has put in position as the head of the department. But what happens?
That man, if he's doing things wrong, we need to know about it. We go to him, and we establish if it's validity to what you're talking about, we're gonna make it better. He's gonna handle the thing. I mean, it's got to work that way. And if we're hiding it, we're doing the employee and the supervisor wrong. And that's the way the military worked it. My whole environment was done based upon that. People lied depending upon whether or not people were adequately doing their job or whatever. And I think we're fooling ourselves if we cover up and don't do it. When he comes to you and you don't carry forward, you're not doing your job. That's the way I look at it.
And I want to make sure he keeps his job, and
that's
why I look at it.
I don't know.
I can complain all day. Nobody can fire me or treat me indifferent. I don't have to be there 9 to 5 or 8 to 5 or whatever. I can go and complain about how if Steve, my department head, and I go complain to you about it, he goes to him. Now he can treat me and make my job the worst place ever.
Well, I don't think it's happening. If it does happen,
that's what I'm saying. What happens when
does it happen? I don't know of any instance this happened.
I'll put a question to this matter. Can I go ahead and on this section 2, we'll go ahead and prove this section 2. This is my motion. Prove section 2, all but deception of the merit raises. Take that off.
How will we change that statement? Salary
increase? When salary improve, we just delete all of that salary increase, consider any funding, just do away with all that. Where we started when, ended at determinations, we take that off and just leave the annual evaluations are important and provide that. That's fine. That's what it's for. But we need to delete my motion. Delete the when salary increases, we need to delete that. If we want to give them anything like that, we need to, bring before the council or something like that. I have no problem about that. The department head can take them out to eat. I don't have no problem with that, raises.
Your motion is to strike that last sentence.
Yes, sir.
Do I have a second to the motion?
Second.
Have a motion and a second. All in favor, say aye.